Oh, and the glorious, glorious fade outs of the 80s, late 70s, early 80s. It's a little Abacab by Genesis. Oh, how y'all doing? Thank you for joining us. It is Midwest Miniature Guys, Work in Progress Wednesday night stream. How y'all doing? Hope you're having a good night. Hope you had a good day. We are going to be continuing work on the Stormcast Eternal, the painting competition figure that I've been working on the past couple of streams now. We got the gold all done on Monday. We got the blue mostly done. I don't know if I'm going to dink around with it too much. So tonight we're going to be working on the white tabard, the leather bits, and then maybe get started on the steel non-metallic metal. Depends on how far we get in the next couple of hours. So let's go ahead and get started. So we had based, so here's the figure, if you haven't been following along, here's the figure we've been working on. So we based the white tabard. We're doing a warm white. We're not going to be doing a cool gray or blue white. We based it on leather, in leather brown. We did a wash of strong tone from Army Painter over the top of it. And now we're going to go back in with that leather brown to reestablish our base coat. We'll do a mix of tan leather into leather brown, straight up tan leather, and then we start mixing our white in until we get to almost pure white. So, normally I have this prepared, but not busy. And I'm going to put this right there so you can see it. There's our, that's our leather brown. Here is our tanned leather. And then our linen white. And you'll see, jeez Louise, I had this lined up here. This was much lighter. Where is that? There, that's a little bit better. There we go. So I'm just going to take about a brush full of water here. We're going to thin down our paint a little bit. I'm just going to start right up here at the top. Just like that. I'm going to leave some of that in the recesses. I already messed that up right there. So go through, I'm just going to clean that up a little bit. And there's no need to rush this process. You take your time, enjoy painting. There's so many times that I have to hurry up and get something done. that I forget to enjoy the process of painting a figure. Really taking your time, making it look good. Because, you know, it's like, oh, this customer's waiting for this, so I need to get it done, so. Hurry up and pound out those 2, 4, 6 hour paint jobs and get it back to them. This one, since I don't have to have it done until August 1st, I can kind of take my time. Really work the layers here. If you have any questions about painting, please put them up in the chat. I'd love to talk to you about it. We talk about painting, we talk about gaming. Pretty much everything here. Music, movies, general nerd stuff. So we're just reestablishing that color. We're going to leave that in the shadows, so we don't need to highlight that. Like I said before, if it's okay if you take a couple of thin coats, like I said, we really want to just build up our layers here. Pardon me while I shut off my buzzer here. Alright, so now that back part looks pretty good. I don't think I'm gonna need to do any more on that. So now we're gonna mix in our tan leather into our leather brown. Just like that. And this is more of a mid-tone, so it's okay for, right as my camera shuts off for a bit, it's okay if we're just leaving a little bit of the leather brown in the recesses and in the wash. That's fine, that's our shading. We're going to be going all the way up to almost a pure white, so it's just fine if we're doing that. Like I said, just take your time. Work those gradients in. So even though this is going to be in shadow down here, I'm still going to put a little bit, because I've already put a little bit of that leather brown there, but I'm going to put a little bit of it right here. Because there's still reflection from the base. There's light reflecting from the armor. It's okay if you move your figure around too. You don't have to always hold it like this. Flip it around so you can get to the weird, hard to reach places. Right in through here. And we'll do the back just the same. I'm glad I'm doing this after I got the armor done, because if I was trying to do this while I was doing the armor at the same time, I might be going, okay, well, you know, am I doing armor or am I doing cloth? Because it was almost very similar colors that I was using. Now that I've got the armor done, you can tell that it's similar, but it's not going to be. I was using chestnut gold, and these are definitely, you know, more light browns. All right, I think we can start. Go back here. I'm gonna go just with regular tan leather now. Starting to see, we're starting to get into our highlight areas, right in through here, the edges here. going to take a little bit of this linen white. I'm going to mix it right into our tanned leather here. Which I may need to get some more of. Further in the highlights. Just keep working them. Alright, now we're going to our linen white. Just kind of get the top parts here. I'm gonna try to get that a little bit smoother. A little rough right now. There we go. So there's our linen white. So you know we've got that kind of nice brown. It's more of a warm white than it is a stark gray white or a blue white. I'm going to get this a little bit more on the... A little bit more on the light side here. I think I might bring that down just a little bit. So we're getting there. I gotta do the back here. Alright, so now I'm going to grab some pure white here. This is solid white. Gonna mix this into our leather white here. Not leather white, linen white. Okay, sometimes you gotta take a look away. Just see how it looks like. Like 2 or 3 feet away and go, okay, well, that looks pretty good. Because if you're holding it like this constantly, you're staring right at it, you're like, you need a little perspective, so you need to lean back, hold it at arm's length. And then go back and keep working at it. That's part of the armor. Alright, now we're going to go straight, solid white, this is going to be our final highlight because I don't have a brighter white that I'm aware of, I guess maybe my bold titanium white would work, but that's okay. Okay, that's our white cloth. It's all done. Now we're gonna work on the brown. We'll work on the leathers here. And I was using the dark shadow triad here. So it's dark shadow, dark skin, dark highlights. And maybe some leather white. We'll see. Because I know I don't want to stop the dark highlight. I want to keep going. But I know that if I have to reestablish our dark shadow here, because there's a little bit that got rubbed off. On the back here, considering that's where I was holding it the most, so we just need to redo that just a wee bit. So I'm going to mix our dark skin into our dark shadow. I really like this nice flat panel right here. I'm just gonna take it, just go like this, leaving that shadow down there in the recesses. That for the belt. So there's kind of our first mid-tone, I guess I would call it. Now we're going to go for our second mid-tone, which is going to be straight up dark skin. Let's see, if we're going full zenithal, then the lighting is going to be up here. It's also going to be back behind the shield. Welcome in, folks that just joined us. Hope you're doing well. Thanks for popping in for a bit. And there we go. Alright, now we're going to mix a little bit of dark skin highlight into our dark skin. Like I said, this is all about gradients. Constantly mixing paint together. straight up highlight here, dark skin highlight. Just trying to get all the little points here to highlight them, find all the little folds. Go on the edge of this leather bracer, I guess, or gauntlet, something or other. Okay, so I know I needed to go up a couple more highlights. I also need to do the handle of the mace thing here. I'm just going to use the highlight color for that. Otherwise, it would, number one, it would take too long, and number two, I guess I should say, I'm skipping numbers here. It's a very small area. So I could almost, should almost just dry brush it, but I'm not going to. All right, let's see if I have a little... Do I have any white left here? Nope. Okay. So what I'm going to do... I'm actually going to grab some leather white. This is kind of a gray white. I'm just going to get a little pile of that. Some of this stuff away now. I'm just going to take a little bit. I'm going to mix it into my dark highlight. Just like so. And this will probably be my final highlight for the leathers. See where that highlights are now? They're like right there in the glove, the gauntlet or whatever it is. Just hitting the edges and some of the folds here. Let's see if I add a little bit more. it's still not exactly right where I want it to be. I just want it to be more like a gray-brown. Maybe this? Try this. Just doing little dots of this color on the handle of the mace here. Okay, I think that's as far up as we're going to do for highlights on the leathers. And that looks pretty good right now. Don't want to start on the steel yet. So I'm going to take him off the base. I haven't glued him on yet. I'm going to set him off to the side here. And we're going to work on the bases for a bit. Because I am doing a display base. So this base is going to fit in right here. So be able to take the figure out and use it for gaming. So I'm going to use some AK Interactive paint here. I've got, this is going to be more like a sandy base. So I've got golden sand, dark sand, and light sand. I want to see which one of these is actually darker, the golden sand or the dark sand. There's our golden sand. Let's see what the dark sand looks like here. Ooh, boy, that's close. I think the golden sand's a little bit darker. Needs to be shucking it more. There we go. So I'm going to just take a little bit of this golden sand, and I've already used, I think it was Wildwood or something like that. It's a contrast paint that I did for the base color. I'm just going to take this old dry brush, kind of get in here, like so. So there, it's gonna start looking like that. I guess I'm just gonna dry brush the snow out of this. Be a little bit more aggressive here so that we can really get the top parts of the sand that we laid down. We used some GW technical paint to create this base. This one here was already sculpted. So I was trying to match this one to that as much as I could. See, I got some, got that golden sand going on here. Really get it on there. That creates kind of a cool effect over the top of that that darker brown that we put on there. Look at that. We're going to use this. What's this? Dark sand. Let's see what it looks like. Oh, yeah, there we go. Not going to be as generous as we were with the golden sand. I'm just going to hit a couple areas here. I think what I'm going to use this on is actually these pillars as well. So there's that. Now let's see what this looks like. Oh yeah. Yeah, that's better. That's pretty cool looking. All right. I'm going to use the same color here. Pick out some highlights on this. Like so. Real quick. Boom. Done. water off of that. And now we're going to go for the light sand. Get it really good in there. Your brush, mix that in. Then we're just going to go a real light dry brush right over the top. Just like so. See, I want to get the base done so I can actually glue him in and attach him in there. Alright, so that's done there. Now we need to move back onto this one. And this we're just going to go real lightly over the top of what we just did. Just give it some quick little highlights. That. And then we'll use the rest on these. We're just going to go like on the tops. This down here is going to be in shade. Just want to go right on the top. Just like so. There. So that's done, except for putting on some foliage, basically. I might do some grass tufts. I know I want to do some leaves, but they're going to be like brown, kind of dead leaves, which is what I'm going to do with these ones here. But I want to find... do this. These are going to be more like autumn leaves, so we're going to do like some auburn shadow on them. Don't need a lot, and this thing's clogged. Thank you. this. Yeah, that's all I'm going to do on those, because it's base and it doesn't need to be. That's not the focal point. The focal point is the figure. So now I can take hopefully just a little dab here. Right there. Just a little dab. Ah! Yeah, that's fine. That's all right. We saved it. It's fine. Push him right onto that base. There. So when I get him off of here, show you how he's gonna sit. He's supposedly going to sit like that. I'm going to do the base darker too. But yeah, that's how he's supposed to sit. It's just like that. I guess what I can do, the few minutes that we've got left here, put back on here. Let's get a quick. Normally I would paint the border black, but I kind of want to try and, what am I trying to think? I'm trying to meld it or make it look like it's part of this base. And I was tempted, very tempted, to use some technical paint and go around the border actually so it would sit further in to this base here. I might still do that, I'm not sure. Thank you. But these are the leaves that I'm going to use. And I'm just going to use Elmer's glue. Just a little bit of Elmer's glue. Got a good pile of that going. Grab some water. Just gonna thin it down. And then I'm going to put some leaves back in there. I'm just gonna take a pinch and go plop, plop, plop. Like that. And then just right back off. See, now we got our leaf piles back in there. Let's get a amount of leaves going. I think I want to put some back in here. So it looks like it's been blowing around. We even got a little twig in there, that's pretty cool. So there, now it looks like the wind has been blowing like this direction and pushing those leaves into all those little nooks and crannies. Like I should even put a little bit more like back in here. Even like up on the some right back in here. So there, now we've got a really cool, we're trying to make this base starting to come alive now. Look at all the nice leaves that we've got in there. We got even like a little twig that got stuck in there. I do not want to blow that. Move that away from there. Now, looking to see what all I've got here. I don't want to do any flowers. I do like the Highland Tuff, though. Gonna use the same glue. And we're gonna start putting tufts of grass in and around our rocks here. Oh, come here, you. That's a fine spot right there. We can even do, like, multiples. Actually using a little bit of super glue here for this. So I'm just gonna get a dollop of that. Boop, boop. I may use up all of this. That's fine. I'll just go get some more. Last one. No, All right, well, we only got a couple more minutes left. I'm gonna leave the steel for on Sunday when I come back, and we can start working on that. But for the most part, we're pretty close to being done. The only thing I've got left, we got the gold and the blue all done on Monday. Now we've got the white tabard and the leather done tonight, along with the base. So yeah, but the only thing that we've got left on the figure is the steel. So we've got like the mace, the hammers here, along with these beads, and on the shield, which is these thunderbolts or lightning bolts here. I do need to paint the back of the shield because that's not painted yet. That should be pretty easy. I just got some gray primer and put it in there and then doll it up. Won't be hard. Probably just paint it blue like that. And then he will be all done. I guess I also got to do like these little, what do you call them? Rivets or something? Anyway, they're right here. But, let's see what he looks like. Let me put him fully. Well, that kind of screwed that up. Okay, not bad. That actually looks pretty cool. I gotta do some work actually on the on this section, because I need to darken that up. Blow off some of that dust and leaves and stuff. I shouldn't have put that one there. Move that. But yeah, that should. There we go. Now we'll fit in there about better. Yeah. That looks pretty darn cool. Then I can do the nice black base. Sweet. Well, folks, we will see you on Sunday. Thank you all for watching. I greatly appreciate it. Hope you have a wonderful rest of the night. Let's see who's... Commander Root. Feels good, man. Long username. Lead Logic, how you doing? Another TV viewer, 47. Thank you all for watching tonight. Like I said, I greatly appreciate it. I'll be back on Sunday. Have a good evening. Bye.